Hello everyone, bon vendredi tout le monde. Ce matin, je veux parler de la troisième vague et des mesures qu'on continue de prendre pour vous protéger. Commençons d'abord par le sujet des voyages.
There has been a significant rise in COVID-19 cases in certain parts of the world, as well as the emergence of more variants of concern. So yesterday, we announced new and even stronger travel measures. Since last night, all passenger flights coming into Canada from India and Pakistan are suspended for 30 days. Now we know that it's not only about direct flights to Canada. That's why there will also be additional measures for passengers departing from India or Pakistan who come to Canada via indirect routes. These passengers will need to obtain a negative COVID-19 pre-departure test from the last country they traveled through before arriving in Canada. Just like when we suspended flights from the UK last December for similar reasons, our government will continue to do whatever it takes to keep Canadians safe. Ces restrictions s'ajoutent au prolongement jusqu'au 21 mai des autres mesures déjà renforcées. Les mesures en place incluent les tests avant et après l'arrivée au pays, la quarantaine stricte et le séjour à l'hôtel aux frais des voyageurs pour ceux qui arrivent en avion. Elles sont obligatoires et elles sont parmi les plus strictes au monde. Ceux qui ne les respectent pas font face à des conséquences très sévères.
This morning, I also want to talk about the situation with the third wave here at home. As you may have seen, Dr. Tam presented new modeling projections earlier today. Across the country, the number of daily new cases has more than doubled in the past month. Hospitalizations have also increased and are still increasing. And there are more contagious and more dangerous variants out there. The situation is critical. But we can, and we will, beat back this third wave. What we have to do is clear. We need to stay home and avoid in-person contacts. And if you absolutely need to go out, in other words, for essential reasons, continue to follow public health guidelines. While we work around the clock to vaccinate as many Canadians as possible, as quickly as possible, we all have to keep practicing physical distancing. I understand that there's a lot of COVID fatigue right now. We all feel it. But the more we reduce our contacts, the faster we will end this third wave. I know it's not easy, but remember, this is not forever. We just need to hang in a little while longer. We need to protect our loved ones and essential workers. And if we do what we know we can do together, we will get through this. So far, we've delivered almost 14 million vaccine doses across the country. 30% of eligible adults in Canada have received at least one vaccine. Next week, we'll get almost 2 million doses, including our first 300,000 doses from Johnson & Johnson. Vaccine doses continue to be the good news we all need in what has been a very tough spring. While more and more Canadians are getting vaccinated right now, it's also important to plan ahead for the future. We've reached an agreement with Pfizer for 35 million booster doses for next year and 30 million in the year after. This deal includes options to add 30 million doses in both 2022 and 2023, and an option for 60 million doses in 2024. Pfizer has been a solid partner for Canada in this fight against COVID-19, and we're happy to be one of the first countries to secure an agreement with them going forward. These boosters will be the latest version of the Pfizer vaccine based on research and testing, and they will help us keep the virus under control. And the work doesn't end there either. We're on ongoing discussions with other vaccine manufacturers about their plans for booster shots too.
Pour maintenant et pour l'avenir, il est important de continuer à développer notre capacité de développement et de production de vaccins ici au Canada. À ce sujet, j'aimerais féliciter la compagnie Medicago, basée à Québec, qui est maintenant la première compagnie canadienne à avoir soumis son vaccin candidat contre la COVID-19 à Santé Canada. Ça démontre qu'on a du talent et du savoir-faire ici au Canada, et notre gouvernement va toujours être là pour encourager les scientifiques et l'expertise de chez nous. Avant de terminer à propos des vaccins et de passer à un autre sujet, je suis très heureux de partager que Sophie et moi allons recevoir notre première dose de vaccin cet après-midi. Comme l'Ontario a invité les gens de 40 ans et plus à recevoir le vaccin d'AstraZeneca en pharmacie, c'est maintenant notre tour. On a bien hâte. C'est un soulagement de savoir que ce simple geste aide à se protéger soi-même, mais surtout de protéger ceux qu'on aime autour de nous. Alors, si c'est votre tour, je vous invite à prendre rendez-vous le plus rapidement possible. En faisant tous notre part, on va vaincre ce virus. Sophie and I are looking forward to getting our first dose of AstraZeneca this afternoon at the pharmacy just around the corner from here. So if you're eligible for your vaccine like we are, make sure you get your dose as soon as possible. Our role as government is to keep Canadians safe. We're ready to do whatever it takes to get this third wave under control in Ontario, in Alberta, and everywhere else in the country. On that front, today, I have some updates to share. Stopping the virus from spreading is key. Since March, we've sent over 400,000 rapid tests to Ontario alone, and we're in the process of sending hundreds of thousands more. We're working with the Ontario government, the Red Cross, and pharmacies to distribute more rapid tests while making it easier for businesses to access them. We've also delivered medical equipment like oxygen units and ordered more therapeutics. And while we do all this, we're working with the Ontario government to send support to their frontline workers as soon as possible. We've identified up to 100 healthcare professionals, like ICU nurses and doctors, who can be deployed rapidly from federal departments to places they're needed most, including the GTA. This is the moment to all work together. Newfoundland and Labrador has offered healthcare resources and identified teams ready to go as early as next week. Other provinces and territories are looking what they can deploy, too. We're ready to provide transport support and funding to enable them to help out where needed in Ontario. In fact, we've set aside $80 million in emergency funding to support the costs of these efforts. To frontline workers in Ontario, in Alberta, and across Canada, you are doing an incredibly important but hard job right now, and we're here to help. And to everyone who's stepped up to help their fellow Canadians, well, that's just who Canadians are. We're there for each other in times of difficulty, but thank you for showing the way. The only way to beat this virus is by working together as a team, so thank you all for doing your part. Cette semaine, avec le budget de 2021, on a présenté notre plan pour finir notre lutte contre la COVID-19 et pour aider les Canadiens à se remettre de cette crise. On veut faire en sorte que tous les Canadiens aient accès à de bons emplois, que les mères et les familles aient accès à des services de garde abordables et que nos aînés les plus vulnérables aient davantage de soutien. Par-dessus tout, on veut construire un Canada plus sain et plus sécuritaire pour tout le monde. C'est pourquoi on rehausse nos ambitions climatiques. Hier et ce matin, j'ai participé au sommet des dirigeants sur le climat organisé par le président Biden. J'y ai partagé notre nouvelle cible climatique pour 2030, qui sera maintenant de 40 à 45 % sous le niveau des émissions de 2005. J'ai aussi mentionné nos investissements dans le transport en commun, les rénovations énergétiques résidentielles et l'électricité propre. As I said yesterday during the U.S. Climate Summit, Canada is raising our ambition once again on climate action. The strengthened climate plan we presented last December, along with our new Budget 2021 investments, will allow us to build a cleaner future and create good middle-class jobs.